In this teaching tip video, you will learn about Bloom's taxonomy so that you can effectively teach this concept in your own courses. We will cover 6 different aspects of Bloom's taxonomy: the knowledge level, the comprehension level, the applicationing level, the analysis level, the synthesis level, and the evaluation level. Let's get started, shall we? Bloom's taxonomy is named after Benjamin Bloom. It serves as the backbone of many teaching philosophies, in particular, those that lean more towards skills rather than content. Bloom's taxonomy is designed to address the process of learning as opposed to objectives related to lesson planning, teacher questioning, assessment, etc. It is broken up into 6 different levels of learning. These levels are hierarchical, so learning at the higher levels is dependent on having attained prerequisite skills at lower levels. Also, the higher levels are more complex than the lower levels. The awareness and understanding of these levels and where students are in the learning level structure of Bloom's taxonomy can better enable educators to effectively advance their students' learning of the subject. Educators can teach their students based on the assumption that students have already advanced to a certain level of learning within this structure, or not. One way that educators can determine this is by identifying students' use of action verbs. These are verbs which literally describe what students should be able to do with subject knowledge at a particular level within the Bloom's taxonomy structure. So, what are these different levels of learning? Let's find out. Number 1. The knowledge level. At the base of this diagram is the knowledge level. This is the most basic level within the learning structure. At this level, students should be able to recall facts, terms, and basic concepts. Action verbs at this level include words such as identify, describe, name, etc. As you can see, these action verbs are almost synonymous with the definition of the knowledge learning level, and they should work that way at each level within the structure. Number 2. The comprehension level. At this level, students should be able to compare like terms to combine and interpret basic information. Action verbs at this level include words such as summarize, convert, and defend. Number 3. The applicationing level. At this level, students should be able to use or apply knowledge to solve problems in new situations. Action verbs at this level include words such as build, make, and construct. Number 4. The analysis level. At this level, students should be able to break up any new information into parts to identify reason, causes, or motives. They should be able to find evidence to support a point of view. Action verbs at this level include words such as breakdown, distinguish, and separate. Number 5. The synthesis level. At this level, students should be able to combine different types of information and to form alternate solutions. Action verbs at this level include words such as categorize, generalize, and reconstruct. And number 6, the evaluation level. At this level, students should be able to defend an opinion or finding based on evidence. Action verbs at this level include words such as appraise, critique, and justify. In this video, we covered 6 different aspects of Bloom's taxonomy: the knowledge level, the comprehension level, the applicationing level, the analysis level, the synthesis level, and the evaluation level. Now that you know more about Bloom's taxonomy, you should be better prepared to teach about it in your courses. Good luck!